So good evening, everyone. This is Likita, and today we are here with Lakshman Tarikonda, who is studying BBA third year at SRM University. So we are pretty excited that he's here today, and he's going to be a business icon in the marketing today in the future. So you'll understand why we are saying so. So let's just dive right into it. So hello, Lakshman. How are you?
Yeah, hello.
So
firstly, a great evening to everyone, and I wish you an happy Pongal. At the same time, happy Sankranti to everyone from the different regions. I hope everyone is doing great.
So let's get started. So Lakshman, you always wanted to run and own, and like you always had an interesting business idea from your 10th standards, right?
Yes.
So as of now, Lakshman has three own ventures of his own. So can you tell me about the first one?
The first one is Gifting World India. We started it in 2018 at the same. From that, it's been running by my and my other employees. It started with one employee, and today in 2022, we have around 16 employees working for it. And right now, we haven't specially upgraded version of the Gifting World that is nothing but talented crew, which is incubated with the help of Hatch Lab, the research center of SRM University. So this is the main centric of the Gifting World, is to provide a customized gifting solutions for the customers, arranging from a different background or different kind of maybe attributes and all. Like, this is all about Gifting World is all about supplying of a gifts which are very really customized and would be helpful.
So why did you get started with this, and like what inspired to do like a project like Gifting World under you?
The first thing is like Gifting World, when I just want to start it, it's like all my family people are into the business from ages, like before the maybe their after the parents and all. Like, this has been a very great pitch for us to start at the time. Like, when I completed my 10th and I just want to be in a part of intermediate course, I just started this Gifting World with an ideation to understand the business world, to understand how really the business are doing, what is the market, how really the market is attracted by the customer, like by the sellers, and how really the concepts of each management works, and not management to be a part, like how each part of business works. My major idea was to learn. My major idea of any company was to learn the things. But end of the day, there is one major call for every company, that is profits. That is secondary for me. My first pitch was to learn. So the learning era or learning thing made me to start the company of 50 more.
So basically, your family's like runs business and also it drove you towards that goal. Yeah. So this Gifting World, when it like you start your first venture in like what year or something?
It's in 2018.
Like, how was the growth, you know, with this venture?
The growth was very to be frank, like growth was not such easy. It took a lot of curves, maybe some ups and maybe some downs. But to be frank, from that day to today, we are very happy. We reached our goals. On the first days of our Gifting World, we used to receive one or two orders per day, like for 1.5 months or 2 months, we received the same. But today, we receive around 400 orders per day. It's not a small amount for us. We only can sustain for 400 to 500 orders, not much than that. We don't even have a capability to run it. So we have 400 to 500 orders per day today.
To be honest, like that's really a huge number, you know, at our age, you've been the third year and you're managing like your own business. So, you know, also like, do you guys have any website for your company, or like how can one person reach out to you?
Well, regarding to the Gifting World, we don't have any website. Soon we may be launch it, name of it, talentedcrew.in. Currently, from last 4.5 years, we are taking in WhatsApp orders, and they can add in our broadcast and other kind of social media platforms. They can add like Instagram and Facebook and other kind of social media platforms. They can directly ping us there. At the same time, they can even call or WhatsApp us. Like this, all the deals right now, we are currently dealing on WhatsApp and social media and in office.
Oh, wonderful. So what about your second venture? What would you like to like tell people about it?
So second venture is Thycot Boost Private Limited. We named the company brand as VPlan Solutions. So VPlan Solutions, we started in 2020. To be frank, this VPlan Solutions is very a prototype where we include ESS, education support services, and IT, the information technology, what we have in the regular life. To be frank, it can be seen as a part of an hybrid version of ESS and online, so online IT or something.
So like what exactly do you do there and like provide customers to it?
So when I was coming to the Thycode Boost, we provide IT based service firstly and ESS. The major prototype version of our company is ESS. There are something which we even call like ESS is education support services basically. So it's a kind where we provide an education support services. Education support services may be in terms of examination, cell kind of thing, or something like we also provide them examination and task submission portals, websites, and other kinds of things which help in building an online kind of resource platform for their education system. Like this happened in COVID time, so we majorly concentrate on the same. Like we concentrate on building this kind of system where it's completely concerned about bringing in virtual schooling experience for the student.
So like basically you approach schools and if they're interested, they come to you and buy your services.
Yes.
Oh yeah. And also I would like to ask this question, like how much of support can you give to someone like who's coming to you as a customer and like what services?
So like our products, to be frank, like we not created it for the universities or something. Like our agenda was to sustain this product in very low level, like schools and colleges, not in an big universities or something. Like the ideation phase was to give a great impact on a schooling. The other thing is everything here is very simplified, like not a complex version. If something like in a university, if he's a BTech student or something, he can learn the things very easily. He can even understand the things very easily. But coming to a school's version or inter-college at the same time, they don't understand the technological in a very high level. So our idea was to do it in very in a simplex complex at the same time in a professional way. That is our basic idea to work on. So this is our product overall agendical strike and all.
You're a BBA student, right? How did you get your interest towards technology?
Technology is something like an it's for everyone. It's not for someone who is gonna use it for today or not to for tomorrow. It's for everyone. So it's not only for one person. It's not only for one kind of field or something. Like a person who is doing his BBA or MBA, he can use his technology. A person who is doing his intro or something like civil score and civil kind of other things also, they can use the technology. Technology is something, it's present in every study. Like adopting that is very hard, and we need to try to adopt it. It's like everyone can adopt it. It's not only a part of any stream and all.
I mean, I wish all the BTech students were like you, and you know, we had some ventures of our own. But yeah, now can we like get to know about your third venture?
So the third one is LHS Labs Private Limited. In a simple name, we call it as Incubators Lab. So it's basically a kind of incubation center where we work on startup incubations. Not only on the startup incubations, we morely work on the things which are really great regarding to the training and development of startups. Like generally, when you see any kind of startup incubation center, they only work on startup incubation. Like if someone is coming with an ideation, they get this idea into some VCs kind of panel, and they ask the VCs to invest, maybe some modification from VCs, then they go and invest on it. But whenever coming to the incubators lab, we deal it very differently. If any person who is ready to come and join us, there is a complete different set of protocol what we use. Like we can even call it as a standard operation procedures, because there is clearly different phases he need to pass out. Like maybe which helps the VCs to invest. It's not like us to help out, but VCs to invest. Because see, from a part of VC, he will not be, he or she will not willing to be spare a lot of time with the person. He directly want what is the portfolio clearly. But whenever we see the entrepreneurs or someone who is doing right now, they are doing everything in a good pitch. But the losing point, what they are losing is to present it under the VCs. So like they may be also presenting good. I don't mean they are not presenting good, but what they may be doing is they may be doing some other kind of not pitching the correct things, like maybe in a market situation or something else. So this is the problem what everyone will be getting when they are into the VC's panel and all. So what we do is before going to the lot of things like exercising them, if someone comes with an idea, we make into ideation phase where they emphasize their idea, and you then the mentors Mark, phase where they can do mentor approaches, they can talk with the mentors and they can exchange the things or they can make some more things. And in the other phase, they may be in a marketing phase or market analysis phase. Like these things will do two things. Like an entrepreneur or anyone who want to be a part of incubate his startup, he will know what's the real value of the market. He will understand what is the real things, what happening, how this startup is going to work and all. So he from entrepreneur side, it was the best point. And coming to the point of VCs, when this all analysis are done, like all the project cost, project analysis, market analysis, and everything is done, VC will be very he feel more efficient to invest in the startup. So that's the reason we make it in that's the reason I call you on standard operation procedures, where we make it into the finest panel. That's what we need. Like making it into a different VA or other things, it does not give a good sense. If he is in a very good situation where if the way he can deliver very great to the VC, it would be great. So that's the reason we make it and we find it. This is all about the LHS Labs. And we also provide training for it. So like anyone who was want to join us, they can join. They can have a different training programs also regarding to innovation.
So like the third venture that you're talking about is like it provides us all the platform for where the people that, you know, the startup minds can come together. So, but like, I want to know, like, where is this third venture like exactly located?
So we do our work in two ways. So one thing is on offline and another thing is online. Offline version, we accommodate around 50 people for a batch. In Hyderabad, we located in Kitpally, Hyderabad.
So like, what are the location of like other two businesses that you told about?
Gifting World is located in Khammam, and iCall Boost also we are working, like this is also registered in Khammam, but we work remotely in a lot of areas. We have some people who are working from Hyderabad and other people working from other states and all.
As you said that you'll be selecting some people, right? So like how exactly do you select them? What's the selection process that goes behind, in selection?
So like it's not something like selecting only precising few ideas and all. We are just seeking the capability and what is the accuracy of updating that idea, incubating that idea, because all the ideas cannot be incubated. If you want to start something which is related to Starlink or something like you want related to do something in regarding to SpaceX and all, it can't be incubated. Like we have very limited resource with us. So with the limited resource, we can't incubate those kind of different startups and all. So like we only select the few startups where we can work on. We have different ranges like manufacturing, they have service and IT separately. We have wings for the education field and all. Like this wings, what they do is they only select the people where we can work on. Like it's not like selecting them only on based on idea, but all about this. And majorly to be like, if people who are interested to join us, they can directly fill the form in our website, or they can even get this up in our Instagram channels and social media channels. They can directly apply from there. And then after applying, they will be having certain review calls regarding the idea, because we need to see how finest he is willing to work on it, how finest he is ready to keep his time on 2 or 3 months. Like it's not about the cost what he's going to incur. It's more about the time what he's going to incur. Like it should not waste its time at the same time of our time. So we select the persons who are really interested towards this innovation. Like not innovation, towards their idea. Like giving the person who gives a value to his idea. We select on that basis.
So from what we understand is that you started one of your ventures, right before the COVID and one right during the COVID. So like how did COVID affect your ventures?
So effect of COVID is completely there in not only my business, but on every business. But see, to be frank, for every business or any kind of operations what are happening, we always need to seek the opportunities. The opportunities are the, we can say them as the boosters for us. Like every time we will having different kind of situations, different kind of market all the day. But the thing is, we need to ready to face it up. So the thing is, we need to ready to seek the opportunity. Like whenever the market is very different in a way of portrait, we need to create some product innovation, or like we can in service based, maybe service innovation, where we can adopt to the new technology. Like coming to the gifting wall, what we had done is we had created a different kind of innovative gifts. Like one of my employees got this idea to start an virtual gifting, where it's a kind of giving a gifts on virtual, maybe some funky ideas, maybe some further, some kind of bonds which are just usual bonds, and some greetings and all. Like these are on virtual platform, not on real. So because at this COVID time, the first thing regarding to the gifting world, we can't deliver any single product what we have, because all are on pack and all the delivery companies got shut down. So there is no chance like we can send it up. And the other thing is, like, there is also a chance if we send it, there may be a chance of going to COVID protocol and all. So the reason we choose a different part is to sustain the product, and it should not make any problem to the customer. If I send a product and there is some COVID which is going out, and if it reaches this customer, there is maybe a problem. So we thought of bringing in a new kind of product. So like this happened in a series. So to get this new product, it's not such easy, but being a small business, it's a good part. Like we can easily fluidate the things. Like we can change our product from one area to other areas. So that's what we done in terms of gifting world. And regarding to the Thai Code Boost, it started in online in the COVID wave and all. Like it's been an online platform and IT platform. So it's really essential in those times. So this how this is balanced.
So I also heard that you started your own venture from, you know, a single member. Like how many members are there in it right now? The first
right
venture?
Now for Gifting World we have 16.
Mm-hmm.
And for second Thai Code, we have 32 employees who are working around the clock.
Wow. And the last one, Incubator Lab?
Right now it's working under the 40 directors. Platforms and all, like different directors of different companies. It's completely run right now on the base of directors. It's not run by the employees. It's run by the different directors from the different companies.
So yeah, audience, I think you can see that, you know, his business, you know, reaps in good life. You know, to get this at this stage, what business model did you like the whole group of your venture follow?
So like basically talking about the business venture, everyone will have their own kind of business agenda. And I completely believe in only one business venture for every different company, because you can see like three are not in a similar pitch. Gifting World is in managed. At the same time, it also creates some new stuff, applications and all. And LHS is completely service-based, like different. But I completely feel only one kind of business in a market is.
Now we can say that for you, the customers are always kings. And now we understood that you have a specific model. So yeah, Lakshman, can you please share your screen and like tell a few words about it?
So it's basically a small version of seeing business from a parallel universe. So it's more about learning and different kind of business model. At the same time, learning from a parallel universe. See, this is a great pitch for entrepreneurs who want to start now, or people, or not only for entrepreneurs, for any business people who want to start now. It's a great pitch, what I believe in. It's this, we all call it as a business from a parallel universe. Like we all see in a business in a very different view. Whenever we see entrepreneurs, their mindset is something like, always they compare themselves with Tata's, they always compare themselves with Mahindra, they always compare with Reliance. See, we are startups, we are a small business, we start from zeros. How a zero can compare 100? Like we can compare a zero with 100, but see, there are 100 steps in between, 99 steps to reach 100. So what I say to the people who want to learn innovation, who want to start their company, see from a parallel universe. When you start from zero, see one and learn. That's what we all want. And I personally, this is a very prescribed model from a lot of people also, and I just made some changes. I just believe in some changes and I just made it. So there is a one good school of entrepreneurship for everyone who want to learn. I will also share you the school details, the school of entrepreneurship details now on the screen. That is the best school, what I feel, for anyone who want to learn the business. So this is the school of entrepreneurs. This is the school for entrepreneurs, what I believe. So see, like you may be wondering, you just showed us some idli wala photos, some flavor wala photos, bookshelves and pani puri. And you are saying as something, it's really, you may be feeling it's must be crazy of thinking why this school of entrepreneurs is this. So I will share you something regarding to this, what we call this as a different model of entrepreneurship. So basically, whenever we all see this, and whenever we see Sensex or Nifty or government organizations, they always call them as an unorganized sector or something like an unregistered sector or an unorganized sector. But these are more organized than the lot of people or in the MNCs. They are more sensible than them. Like there are few factors and few agendas which made them to stand there, and MNCs are ready to learn from them. And to be frank, two points I just want to say about this unorganized sector, what the people see about the unorganized sector. India's 50% of GDP is contributed from them. So it is one of the best factor. Like see, keeping all the MNCs on one side, unorganized sector on one side, it's very different. So 50% of GDP is not a small one. And second fact is 90% of today's India's employment is in unorganized sector. So better than calling it as an unorganized sector, we can call them as a strengthened sector or school for entrepreneurs. It's everyone will feel like this is an unorganized, but they have more things to learn. So I will share you great pictures of what are they really we need to learn from them. Return on investment. Like when you see, like most of you may be visiting Mumbai at all. Like when you go in Bombay, you will have streets where books are sold, those like street books and all. Like see, return of investment of that pitch at the same time, return of investment in a different pitch. Especially for marketers, there is something, a topic called as find your self space. Like in a, we need to find where our product need to be sustained and all. But see, all the marketers or the people who want to start, they always only think about the pitch, which is in regarding to the maybe in less kind of malls. Like they want to brand it in a mall, they want to brand it in another advertisement center. But the real pitch is when this book or something is placed in this bookstores, because that's the place where everyone buy. And the return of investment on every investment, maybe you can seek it as more than 20% or 30%. Like they have a lot of crisp revenue on it. And the second part is equity distribute of profits. Like whenever you can see like some what we call idli and dosa selling carts on our roads and all. They have very reasonable price, around 20 to 30 rupees. They sell it 20. Approximate, we will think it as 20 rupees. Why I call this equitable distribution of profits? When a person who is selling in this idli or dosa at that centers, the plate may be costing up 20 rupees. He only takes 3 rupees per his share. And other 3 rupees he allocates for food grains. Other 3 rupees he allocates for the workers who work there. Other 3 rupees for grinding wala. Other 3 rupees for the person who brings on this cart. Like, see, he has a very diversified kind of thing where he equally shares all his profit. He does not like, he do not keep 100 rupees with him and he do not give 2 rupees to it. Like, in the same plate of idli, if you're in a 5-star hotel, it's cost of 500 and maximum of its profit is kept by MNC. There is no chance like a person, MNC will, maybe like company not give 100 rupees for me and 100 rupees for rickshaw or 100 rupees at the same time. Like they hold maximum profit in their head. So what I ask people to be part of an entrepreneurship, learn it in a very different way, which is equitable profit. For everyone, there need to be an equitable profit. And other thing is degree of empowerment of decision making. There are people who may be on different flavors and all. Like they sell different kind of flavors, maybe what we call flavors, maybe some other product. Think like a boy who is selling the product. He sells it for 10 rupees and his buying cost is for 7 rupees. He has 30% of his margin. And if someone asks for 8 rupees, he will reduce his margin for 10 rupees and he can take it. At the same time, if someone, if he likes our face or something, he can even give us a 50% of discount at the same time. So this is what happens. So this framework, what shows us is a very in a different way, how quick we can take the decision. If you see an MNC, if you ask a sale manager to give a 5% discount, it need to be from a sales manager to the manager, manager to the board, board to take the decision from the chairman, same person to again. Like toward this all complete journey, this may, he may be also losing his capability of getting this decision, like opportunity also he may be losing, and more fluidity. Why the real beauty of small scale business or small businesses is they can adopt whatever the new product they have. Like we will be having in roads of Charminar and all, we will be having a stalls which are kept for 20 to 30 days, not more than that. Like in holy time, they sell holy kind of things, holies, rangoli and all. They sell for just for 10 to 20 days. They sell them. And after the holy, they shift for the other product. After that, they also shift for the other product. Like see how hard it is to shift from one product to other product. If an any company who want in a good phase or MNC, if they want to change some kind of the product, it takes years. But see the small business, see the local, the unorganized sector, they can change it in a days. Like today they will be selling one product, tomorrow they may be selling another product. That's a change what they basically have. So that fluidity is very high. So that's the reason entrepreneurs or school people who want to start the companies need to learn from them. Like company need to be more fluid. Like they need to seek the market. And the other thing would be different kind of people we may be seeing every day. If you go to some chowks, maybe in Bombay or Mumbai or something, where they sell a lot of products and all, you will be finding a different product in any end of the street. Like maybe from a pichka, water pichkari guns or something, like they have a more different design products. They have a different kind of products all the time. If you see some product today, you won't see it tomorrow. Like they really utilize what are the products, what they are like, the different products they get into the market and equally they share and equal opportunity market. Like everyone in a small scale business, they have an equal opportunity to raise. Like if you go to the Bombay Tyler Street, there is a completely around 400 to 500 shops which sell the same product, which sell at the same cost, and which sell they in the same quality and quantity also. But see, only any person who want to have this will have only the one-time experience. If I am into the Bombay Tyler shop and all, I will buy my suit today and tomorrow it's not sure like I'm going to buy again. If something like Reliance today, I will go and tomorrow also I will go, but not in case of this happens. So this is where we need to learn. Like one time also he's stressing up, he will only have 4 to 5 minutes to pitch his product, only to 4 to 5 minutes to understand the customer, 4 to 5 minutes to sell the product. Like otherwise time, ultimately he will be going to the other one. So this is what really we need. This is what real opportunity is. Like when there is an equal opportunity in a market, we need to try to take it up. It's not like entire market is mine for all the day. Like you may be having a monopolistic when you have a new product for few days, but it's not a monopoly for all the year or all the days. Like maybe right now the situation of technology or right now the situation is like making any product morph or something, like we call it as a replica, just in 1 or 2 days. So think the market is not at all the monopoly all the time. So we need to sustain the market where which has an equal opportunities. So we need to precise ourselves for it and lesson of having enough and coexisting. So this is a short story. I don't want to name anyone here in the face. He's a CEO of XY company. He was traveling from Bangalore to Tunaku, and Tunaku he has someone some special stall where a grandma sells some kind of food and all. So when the CEO is into the grandma's food, she charged us 15 rupees and she gave some roti and other things. He felt it very best than other branded hotels and all, the five-star hotels and all. He felt the food was very great. He, as a CEO, he thought of giving some advice to her. He asked the grandma, like, next time you just given banner kind of poster kind of thing, so everyone will know. At the same time, you increase your mark. So what she had done, like, as an experienced person, someone is saying, so she thought of getting a banner, and for 15 rupees, she charged 30 rupees. Everything got fine, and her revenue stream got increased, and everyone started noticing her shop and all. So this is the first phase, like, having enough. So, like, she is not, like, the second phase of the company, the second phase of the story is she is having enough. The next time when the CEO went to her, the CEO asked the grandma, like, you are always serving rotis and all. Why can't you serve something tea with you? Like, because after a roti, someone may be trying to have a tea, huh? So why can't you have a tea? If I want to sell the product, if I want to sell the same product to the tea, what the other customer, the other person who is behind the tea stall is going to sell? So, like, she has a precise mind. She know her limits. She only want the coexisting. She not want, like, she can start selling the tea so she can also increase the revenue. But her mind is not in the same pitch. Her mind was to coexist in the market. That was the greatest lessons what we need to learn. So that's the reason, after seeing this all factors, that's the reason I called it as a school for entrepreneurs. Like, as a lot of people may be saying, unorganized, but I'm sure, and a lot of people are sure, more than organized markets, they are best in a lot of points. There are a few things which may be helpful for you, and thanks for it. Thanks for this presentation.
So yeah, thank you so much for that. Thank you so much for sharing this with us. I surely hope this helps a lot of people in our college, many students who come up with their own startup ideas and all. Now, I guess now we can all call you a businessman, maybe, you know. So I would also like to ask you about this. What are the main three things that you think one should keep in mind, you know, in order to succeed?
So I feel like three things need to be very much taken into point consideration when someone want to start the company or not only to start the company. If people also started, they can also use them to reach some more heights. Something is teamwork, innovation, and thinking ahead. So these three things they can keep in mind. Like, always teamwork is required, 110%. Like, if something like he want to be a part, teamwork, maybe in an initial phase, he will be a part, only he will be doing everything. So you do not want any teamwork. But seeing a company from an ahead, like, maybe after 10 years, he will be having a good team. He need to know how to tackle with the team, how to understand the team, how to make the team into a perfect goal-oriented way. So that's the reason he need to know what is teamwork. And second thing would be innovation. As a lot of people feel innovation, it's something like a product. No, innovation is not only a product. Innovation is something what every person need to utilize in every part of his life. Not only while doing company, not only a company, person who is doing his coding also, he can use the innovation. A person who is doing his civil work also use the innovation. Innovation is to make our life easy. For business persons or for entrepreneurs, it's very much pressured up. It's very much very, they need to keep in mind, always innovate themselves. Innovate them for the opportunities. Innovate them for the other things, what may be happening in the market. Until and unless if the person is not ready to innovate, I'm sure like he will not succeed in his life. And the thing is thinking ahead. Like always, it's something like a sixth sense. Because we always need to think what is the future of the company. If I just started today, it's always mean how far I'm going to reach in a sustained day. Maybe 1 year later or 2 year later, what is my point? What is my destiny for the company? It need to be set in a bracket. Like, this is my cup of tea and I need to have that cup of tea. Until and unless this is not ahead, like if he is not ready to do, if he is not willing to know what is happening, what is going to happen in ahead, he is not going to sustain. Like, he want to know what is going to happen in the future. He want to have his clear cut idea what is going to be in ahead. So these three things will always make any person, not only in business, but and student, or like you can integrate these three things in any career, like student, coder, job holder, or job seeker. Anywhere, if he has three things, as I told you, innovation, teamwork, at the same time, thinking ahead, these three things will help him a lot.
Yeah, as a businessman and as a CEO, what are the three things that, you know, help you personally to get your success in your ventures or anything in your life, maybe?
So firstly is, to be frank, like the customer holding, and what I mean is, we always need to know, we always need to keep in mind where we started. We see a lot of people or they don't keep in mind what they have started in. Like, if they started in 100 rupees, if we get 1,000 also, we need to be in the same phase to accept 100. And we also need to be in the same phase. We need to have carry the same attitude when we are having 100, the same. And when we have 1,000, we need to have the same. Like, if I have a confidence of 10% when I'm in 100, in 100,000 also, I need to have the same confidence. It's not like a building up or destroying it in any way. So that is my first key, what I want to utilize. And the second thing is innovating for every change, what is happening, and seeking for the opportunities. So seeking for opportunities is one thing what everyone can use in their daily life. Maybe a job seeker seeks an opportunity for a better hike. Maybe as a business person, I may be seeking for and good kind of maybe a client or something, like an order or something. Seeking for opportunities. So it would be the third one, what I completely feel. This three, maybe what I feel took for my success.
I'm sure that your company has, you know, faced many difficult situations like many other companies. If I had to ask a situation where you like found a particular difficult situation and, you know, you solved it in a very cool manner, what would you say? You know, what is the situation that comes into your mind?
This happened in gifting world. As I previously also told you about the product innovation, what we got in the COVID time, as I told you, a lot of lockdowns happened, this all things happened, but there is no chance of doing business. Like, it's completely to be frank to say, it's something like an shitting of the business. But at that time, we had created a different we got a different opportunity. It's not a creation of opportunity. We had created a solution for the opportunity. That's it.
And you grabbed it.
Yes. Like, we got virtual giftings, and it clicked into the market, and we got a good revenue at that time of this virtual gifting, something like a frames. They have digital arts, digital paintings. And they can like a lot of things. So like some funky bonds for lovers and all like this. This is something like funky kind of products which we got virtually. That is the coolest thing what we had done for gifting world.
And the other question. So if we ask you to tell one unforgettable moment, like what situation would come into your mind?
Always the first order will be the unforgettable moment, not only for me, any person holding his business, the first order or the first what we call the treat after the customers give us an appreciation. It was the first, always stands first. Like, first experience is the best experience ever. That's fact. And every, maybe in terms of education or something, it really stands as a fact. First experience is the best experience. So like, when we have an first client, it shows us, like, not only for me, any kind of small business holder or something, it shows us clearly that your idea is gone working. Like, you are not doing something bad, you are doing something good, and it's very pleasantable or something. So that was the first experience, and the best experience always I have first customer experience.
So what are your like future plans for your ventures?
My future plan is, firstly, my current plan is to get this LHS labs, the incubator labs, into a good and finest space where we can incubate a good number of startups and all. And my, like, regarding to LHS labs, my dream is to at least to handle 1,000 students per program. That not only students or entrepreneurs, maybe 1,000 students per batch, 1,000 students per program. That's my first and the future. My first future goal would be regarding LHS Lab, like taking it in a good phase and keeping it a good time. Another thing would be my family business always. As a part of being a family business from years, like my dad was doing it from years. So I also want to be in a family business and I want to take it into a head. That's my two future goals. Currently, what are my future goals? It's been two, these two.
So like what's a family business like, you know, that you found inspired?
My father is a founder of, like he has a grounded processing unit where we process the seeds and all. So it's my dream to make it into his vision, not into my vision. He has an excellence vision to take into a good and best in all over the Telangana. So I always want to be a part of that his vision. And maybe some other day, I want to deserve his vision and I want to make that vision into a successful vision.
Well, thanks to him that you inherited his, you know, habits and you got into this business too. Now that you have three business ventures under you, do you think you can take like any of the SRM students or like to work with you or work under you?
Always, not only from a part of SRM, from any part, we are ready to accept the students into us, into our family. That's always we want. Even like we are ready to recruit the people, we are ready to have people from themselves, and fortunately I have my friends from the SRM University same in my batch who are right now also working with the labs of LHS. His name is Harshvardhan Devineni. He's also a part of LHS labs. Like, it's more about opening. Everyone from SRM University are welcome for any company we have, with a complete heartful welcome for them, anyone who want to join.
So maybe in the future, you'll recruit some of us too and even come join your company.
Sure.
So yeah. Maybe. So yeah, I think we come to the end of the session. I mean, I got to say, Lakshman, you're like a person of word and like work and not words, you know. I've seen what it is in the meeting also. So yeah, thank you for coming and thank you everyone who attended the meeting. So yeah, see you everyone next time.